this experiment, we will see how a capacitor works in a circuit when connected in series and parallel to other elements in the circuit. For this, we will need a capacitor. We are using a 220 microfarad and 25 volt capacitor for the experiment today. There are two leads on the capacitor. The longer lead is the positive lead and the shorter lead is the negative lead indicated by a minus sign. We have connected a piece of red insulated wire to the positive lead of the capacitor and black insulated wire to the negative lead. For doing this experiment, we will also need a 9 volt battery connected to a battery snap and crocodile clips. Again, we have connected a red crocodile clip to the positive terminal of the battery and a black crocodile clip to the negative terminal of the battery. We are connecting an electronic buzzer in the circuit. We have connected a red insulated wire to the positive lead wire of the buzzer and a black insulated wire to the negative lead wire. In the first setup, we will connect the capacitor in series to the buzzer. For this, first connect the red crocodile clip from the battery snap to the red insulated wire connected to the capacitor's positive lead. Next, connect the black insulated wire from the capacitor's negative lead to the red lead wire from the buzzer's positive lead. You can see that the black crocodile clip from the battery and the black lead wire from the buzzer are the only free leads. To complete the circuit, let's connect the black crocodile clip of the battery to the negative terminal of the buzzer and observe what happens. You will observe, once the black crocodile clip is connected, the buzzer buzzes for a short while, but the sound slowly dies down. Why does this happen? In the second setup, we are connecting the capacitor in parallel to the buzzer. To set up the capacitor in a parallel connection to the buzzer, connect the red wires from the buzzer and the capacitor's positive terminals to each other. Next, connect the black wires from the buzzer and capacitor's negative terminals to each other. Now, connect the red crocodile clip from the battery to the junction of the two red wires between buzzer and capacitor. Next, we will connect the black crocodile clip from the battery to the junction of the two black wires between buzzer and capacitor. You will notice the buzzer is now buzzing. Let's disconnect the black crocodile clip and observe what happens. You will observe the buzzer continues to buzz for a few seconds even after you disconnect the clip. Why does this happen? A capacitor is used in almost all electronic and electrical appliances today for their ability to store a charge. The capacitor is a passive circuit element that is made up of two plates of conductive material separated by a dielectric. The conductive plates are good conductors of electricity, whereas the dielectric is an insulator or a very poor conductor of electricity. When a capacitor is connected to a power source, it charges up to the point where its charge voltage is equal to the voltage of the power source, that is the battery in the circuit, say. When the charge voltage of the capacitor equals the voltage of the battery, current does not flow through the capacitor and the circuit is broken or opened. In the series connection, once the circuit is closed, the buzzer starts to buzz. However, the sound dies down and the buzzer goes silent soon. This is because as the current starts flowing in the circuit, the charge on the capacitor starts increasing. Once the charge voltage of the capacitor equals the voltage of the battery, the circuit is broken and current no longer flows through it, which causes the buzzer to stop buzzing. In the parallel connection, the buzzer and capacitor's positive terminals are connected to the positive of the battery and the negative terminals are connected to the negative of the battery. When the power is turned on, the current flows through the buzzer and the capacitor parallelly, charging the capacitor and making the buzzer buzz at the same time. Once the capacitor is charged to the battery voltage, current no longer flows through it. However, this does not affect the flow of the current to the buzzer, which is why it continues to buzz, unlike in the series connection where it stops buzzing soon after the circuit is closed. When the crocodile clip is disconnected or the power is switched off, the capacitor discharges through the buzzer and the buzzer continues to buzz mildly till the capacitor discharges completely. The capacitor acts as a charge storage that provides current flow to the buzzer in the absence of a voltage source.